Now let us see what is the point of counterflexure. In overhanging beams, there will be a point where bending moment will change its sign from negative to positive or vice versa, that is positive to negative. Such point is called the point of counterflexure or point of inflection. So this generally happens in overhanging beams. The bending moment for some part it is plus, and after that some part it is minus, like that. So whenever bending moment changes its sign, that point is called the point of counterflexure. Now let us consider a problem here. This is the overhanging beam, that is supports are at A and B, and BD is overhanging part. At D it is 15 kN point load is there. In between A and C it is UDL, but total load is 80 kN. It is directly given. So the lengths are shown, 3 meters here, 3 meters and 2 meters. So that we take the taking moments about A. So in order to find out the reaction at B, RB, it is RB into 6 is equal to 15 into 8. 15 is point load. We are taking moments about A means total distance we will take. 3 plus 3 plus 2, that is 8, plus 80 into 1.5. 80 is total load for this UDL, which is acting at middle of 3 meter, that is 1.5. So by calculation, RB is equal to 40 kN. The total load is equal to sum of the reaction, that is RA is equal to total load minus RB. So RA is equal to 55 kN. Now we draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. The shear SFD is calculated by this way. Let us consider the portion between A and C. So from A you take a distance x, that is section, at the particular section the shear force is RA minus 80 by 3 into x. RA is 55 kN. Similarly, you apply the end conditions. At x is equal to 0, we know the shear force, that is reaction, and that is 55 kN here at A. So you substitute that. Similarly, at x is equal to 3, the shear force is minus 25 kN. So whenever the shear force is 0, that is fx is equal to 0, in 55 minus 80 by 3 into x, that is equal to 0. So we will calculate x is equal to 2.0x. So here this is whenever the shear force is 0. Similarly, shear force between C and B is constant. Here you see C and B, there is no load. So same constant shear force is acting here, that is 25 kN. Similarly, in between B and D, we calculate the shear force, that is RA plus RB minus AT, 15 kN. Similarly, bending moment calculations. Between A and C, mx is equal to RA into x minus 80 by 3 into x by 2. So we will get some equation, 55x minus 40 by 3x square. End conditions, at x is equal to 0, bending moment is 0. At x is equal to 3, we calculate this. That is, x is equal to 3 means at C. So MC is equal to 55 into 3 minus 40 by 3 into 3, 56.7 kilonewton meter. When X lies between C and B, you take the general equation. Bending moment in between B and C is RA into X minus 80 into X minus 1.5. So by calculation, we will get this X. To 120 minus 25x. So at end condition, x is equal to 3, mc is equal to you put x is equal to 3 here. At x is equal to 6 in the same equation, we will get mb minus 30, mc 45. So bending moment is 0. That is at point of contraflexure. So you take this 120, same equation, 120 minus 25, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 4.8. So x lies between b and d. We will calculate the bending moment at these different points, and we draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. We take a problem here. A beam AB 20 meter long supported on two intermediate props 12 meters apart carries UDL 6 kN per meter together with concentrated loads 30 kN at left end and 50 kN at the right end. The props are so located that the reaction is same at each support. Determine the position of the props and draw SFD and BMD. Mark the values. Here the T this current. Here the total load we will calculate, 30 plus 50 point loads plus 6 into 20, it is 200 kN. So it is, reactions are equal, that is 200 by 200 kN, because this is given in the problem. The props are so located that the reaction is same at each support. So reactions are equal, total load by 200 kN. Taking moments about A, 50 into 20 minus 100 into 12 plus A minus 100A plus 6 into 20 into 10, on calculation we will get A is equal to 5 meters. What is this A? It is the distance from left end to the support at C, A. Total length of the beam is 20. In between the props is 12. So we are assuming A to C is A. So the distance between DB is 20 minus 12 is 8. So from 8 you subtract A, 8 minus A, that is the distance. So we calculated it here. The remaining is shear force. This is another method, just left hand side to B is plus 50 kN. Just right hand side to D is plus 50 plus 6 into 3, that is UDL. Because A is equal to, we got this 5 meter. So here distance between D and B is 8 minus A is 3, 8 minus 5 is equal to 3. So that length we are taking, 6 into 3. Like that shear force just left hand side to D is previous value, okay? Minus 100, and this is a reaction. Reaction is upward force. So shear force convention minus we will take reaction at D. So minus 60. Similarly, shear force just right hand side to A, previous value plus 6 into 5. Like that, shear force will become 0 at a distance x from B. You see this, from B, this distance we will take. So here to here, shear force is 0. That is at E we are indicating. So x calculation is, shear force at x is 50 minus 100 plus 6x square. So by calculation we can take this, x is equal to 8.33. In the same manner, bending moment at B is 0. Bending moment at D is minus 50 into 3 minus 6 into 3 into 1.5 minus 177. Bending moment at C is given by these values. Bending moment at X, we calculate here. X is 8.33. So you substitute in that, we will get bending moment at X is minus 91.7. So we plot this shear force diagram and bending moment diagram with the given values. Since it is total UDL, all the curves in the bending moment diagram are parabola. These curves,